Hello everyone, in this video we have one square and one quad circle, point A and point C. These are given as tangent point, and point D is the center of the quad circle. This length is given 4 units, and here is given 2. The question is, what is the area of the square? First step, I want to represent the length of the EC with X. Notice that point C is tangent point. That means we can apply tangent second third. Right? Therefore, according to tangent second theorem, X squared must be equal first part 2 times second part, 6. So x squared equals 12. That means x equal 2 root 3, right? Let's write here, x equal 2 root 3. And this length, let's call here, y. After that, if you draw a perpendicular line from the center onto the chord like this, the chord will be divided into two equal parts. So these two parts must be equal to units. And then let's call here alpha and here theta. You know that alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees. So angle BAE must be equal alpha, and likewise angle AEB must be equal theta. If you notice that this triangle and this triangle have same angles, that means these two triangles are similar. Let's call here point K. Therefore, triangle AKD and triangle EBA are similar. Right? Therefore, if we apply similarity theorem for this triangle Y, which is opposite of the alpha, over 2, which is opposite of the alpha, must be equal 6, which is opposite of the 90 degrees, and here, this length. This length is y plus 2 root 3, right? So 6 over y plus 2 root 3. Therefore, after the cross multiplication, y squared plus 2y root 3 equal 12. Right? Okay. If we convert this expression to a perfect square, that means y plus root 3 whole squared minus 3 equal 12. Therefore, y plus root 3 whole squared must be equal 15. Let's square root both sides of the equation. These are again, so y plus root 3 equal root 15. Therefore, y is going to be root 15 minus root 3. Right? Okay. Or you can think like this. Let's k create here. Let's call second method. If you focus on triangle ABE, for this triangle, if we calculate sine alpha, notice that sine alpha equal y over 6, right? Likewise, if you focus on this triangle, sine alpha is also equal 2 over y plus 2 root 3. Therefore, if we equalize this two expression, y over 6 must be equal to 2 over y plus 2 root 3. So, after the cross multiplication, y squared plus 2y root 3 equal 12. If you notice that, this equation is the same as the equation in the first method, so y will be equal root 15 minus root 3. Therefore, square area equal y plus 2 times root 3 whole squared, right? You know that y equal root 15 minus root 3 plus 2 root 3 whole squared. This expression is also equal root 15 plus root 3 whole squared. So 15 plus 6 root 5 plus 3. Therefore, square area is going to be 18 plus 6 root 5 units squared. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye bye.